Want to create a website or blog, but not sure which platform is best for you? In this video, we'll compare Squarespace versus WordPress to enable you to pick the right option for you. We'll look at getting started, pricing, design and customization options, and review the features offered by each platform. Squarespace and WordPress are both content management systems, or CMS for short. They allow users to easily publish content online without needing to know web design or development. Whether you want to start a blog, create a business website, or launch an online store, we'll give you the tools to help you make an informed decision on which platform will best suit your needs. So let's get to it and compare Squarespace versus WordPress. We've created an article that accompanies this video and goes into a little more detail. You can access this on the Oakland blog at oaklyn.com/blog. We'll add a direct link to the article in the description below. We'll also include a link to each platform so you can learn more about each option. Firstly, let's take a look at Squarespace. Squarespace is a for-profit software as a service or SaaS company based in New York City. To use their service, you'll need to purchase a monthly subscription that will give you access to the online web building platform via your browser. Everything you use to build your site is made by the Squarespace team of developers, and no outside stuff is allowed. Hosting and other resources needed to keep your site online is all taken care of by them. The pros and cons of this approach will become clearer as we go through the considerations and differences. What about WordPress? WordPress is an open source piece of software. This means that no one owns the framework, and as such, anyone is free to download, use, repurpose, and sell their creations as they see fit. While this gives you a tremendous amount of freedom and flexibility, it also comes with some responsibilities. We'll explore the pros and cons of this as we go through the analysis. As outlined above, the obvious difference between these two platforms is that one is owned by a company and the other is open source. What this translates to is the amount of control the user has over design and functionality, as well as the aspects of the website or blog that the user is ultimately responsible for. To help illustrate this further, we'll examine the process of getting started, pricing, design and customization options, and features for each platform. We'll provide a summary towards the end of this video and outline when Squarespace is a better option than WordPress and vice versa. Let's start by comparing Squarespace versus WordPress in terms of getting started. Getting started with Squarespace is extremely easy. Unfortunately, there is no free subscription, but they do offer a free 14-day trial, no credit card needed. This lets you go through the complete setup process and allows you to see exactly what you're in for. Before you even give them your details, you can browse through the themes available to see what your potential site could look like. Only after you select a theme do they ask for your basic subscription information, like your name and email. You are then guided through a straightforward process, which includes site content. This is the topic of your site, like fashion, travel, photography, etc. Site goals. What do you want to achieve? Do you want high traffic, showcase your work, run a store, or collect donations? Bio. Just a simple description of your site. Some templates will highlight this. And site title. This is basically your site's name. Once you have run through the setup process, you can immediately start editing your site through the simple drag and drop interface. There is almost no learning curve to climb. Any changes you make, you see in real time, and is exactly how your site will look once you publish it. Once you start editing, a helpful video pops up showing you the basics of the drag and drop interface. By comparison, WordPress takes a little more work to get up and running. It's quite straightforward, but there are a few more steps and choices involved. You will need to purchase your desired domain and secure your hosting account. For quality basic hosting, we would recommend Bluehost, who will include a free domain. There's a link to this in the description below. For an e-commerce store, or if you're wanting faster hosting, we can provide access to a discount with WP Engine, also in the description below. We've put together a number of free WordPress tutorials for beginners to help you through these steps. You can either install WordPress via your hosting provider's one-click WordPress installation tool, or if you're a little more savvy, you can install WordPress manually on your domain or in your local environment by downloading the WordPress software from wordpress.org and following the instructions in the readme.html file. The verdict? Well, the first round goes to Squarespace. There is no real learning curve, more of a settling in period. Next, we'll analyze Squarespace versus WordPress from a pricing perspective. Unfortunately, Squarespace doesn't offer a free subscription option. However, all four paid subscription plans come with the tools and support you'll need to be successful. Their plans can be divided into two categories, websites and online stores. Note that all plans come with a free domain for a year if you haven't already registered one. After that, you'll need to purchase a domain from them on a yearly basis. As you can see, even with the most basic plan, you get a decent amount of features. There isn't too much of a difference between these two, although the lower transaction fee and $100 Google AdWords credit is a nice touch. With the business plans, you get access to a number of extra features that might seem like nice-to-haves, but quickly become essential for any serious store. Now you get metrics, accounting, and discounts. You can also get label printing, which helps with efficiency. In short, they provide the tools to create a better shopping experience for clients, enable sales tracking, and monitor user statistics. The self-hosted version of WordPress doesn't have payment plans. For all intents and purposes, the WordPress software itself is completely free. However, it's not as easy as that. To leverage this software to run a successful site, you'll need to consider a number of things, such as your domain, hosting, a WordPress theme, etc. We've put together a more comprehensive list and approximate costs on the Oakland blog. For a complete breakdown, read out how much does it cost to make a website with WordPress article. So, what's the verdict? Well, this one completely depends on your website budget and objectives. Let's explore the design and customization options for Squarespace versus WordPress. If you follow the link to the Squarespace website in the description below, you will immediately be greeted by an immaculately designed site. In fact, it's very Apple-esque. It's minimalist, stylish, and has smooth animations. Everything you would like to see in your own site. Squarespace is serious about design. Most of the other online blogging or website creation platforms have nowhere near the amount of design prowess that Squarespace exhibits. Yes, they still only have around 100 themes available, but they are all beautiful, responsive, polished, and modern. Something very few others can equal. We won't mention any names. The customization options are also pretty extensive. Anything that you see on the theme can be altered to look just the way you want it. In a way, a theme is just a starting point from where you can build the site you want. The What You See Is What You Get, or WYSIWYG editor, is not the easiest one to master, but is probably one of the most powerful. WordPress, on the other hand, has over 1,000 absolutely free themes available. For a theme to be listed in the WordPress theme repository, they are checked for quality and required to adhere to web development standards. With so much going on, however, a bad apple or two may slip through. Also, with these themes, you pretty much rely on the developer's mercy for support. Premium themes solve many of these issues. There are a number of quality theme providers and online marketplaces where you can purchase a theme to meet almost any purpose, many of which either meet or exceed the design brilliance of Squarespace. There is no official headcount, but you can be assured that there are thousands upon thousands of themes out there. They range vastly in quality and function, but you will definitely find exactly what you need if you look around. To help with this, we've created a number of WordPress theme reviews by niche, as well as an article on the top WordPress theme providers and marketplaces, available on the Oakland blog. WordPress's WYSIWYG editor is also just as capable and empowering, allowing you to start customizing your website or blog with little experience or skill. The verdict? WordPress scores a slight win. Yes, there are so many more themes available, but not all are of the highest standard, whereas you are getting consistency from Squarespace. Finally, let's review the features of Squarespace versus WordPress. Squarespace have made the effort to provide enough high-quality features to make any plan worth your money. Up until recently, Squarespace was very restrictive, especially when it came to e-commerce, allowing only one payment method and very limited products. However, they have now made everything unlimited. Squarespace is a closed system, and only plugins or widgets contained in their themes or provided by them are available. You can't use third-party plugins or software. This means you are completely dependent on them for new features. However, you are also guaranteed that all features will be of a high standard and compatible with your site. This is what you can expect when you sign up with Squarespace. Beautifully crafted, high-quality themes, hosting and domain, committed 24/7 support, a complete WYSIWYG editor, and powerful e-commerce capabilities. The most important thing to know is that everything is made by Squarespace, and they have a real focus on quality over quantity. While the world isn't your oyster, every feature is a flawless pearl. WordPress's biggest strength and weakness is that it's open source. With a massive community of active contributors creating themes, plugins, and features, the sky's the limit in terms of what you can do. It also means a lot of badly made software makes its way online, so you will need to be mindful of what you use. Depending on which theme and plugin you use, the functionality and features of your WordPress theme will vary. However, with well over 50,000 plus plugins available in the WordPress plugin repository, plus those available for sale by individual providers and marketplaces, there are very few things you won't be able to do. There are plugins for almost anything, including security, maintenance, backup and migration, SEO, specific features or widgets, user accounts, and page builders. The final verdict? This one can't really go any other way. WordPress is the king when it comes to functionality, flexibility, and features. As you can see, these two platforms are completely different in the way they approach solving the same problem. WordPress can be summarized by flexibility, control, and added responsibility, whereas Squarespace can be summarized by design, service, and restriction. We hope you walk away from this comparison with a deeper knowledge of these two platforms and a clearer picture of which one is right for you. So when is Squarespace a better option than WordPress? One, you don't have any experience with web development and don't have the time to learn. Two, you don't have the money to invest in a developer or expensive support services. Three, you have a clear goal of what your site will be. Alternatively, when is WordPress a better option than Squarespace? One, you have some technical know-how or are comfortable following step-by-step instructions. Two, you have a small budget of about $100 for premium themes, plugins, or courses. Or three, you need or want as broad a horizon as possible when it comes to future features and extensions. Well, that sums up our Squarespace versus WordPress review. If you like this video, hit the like button and remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos related to blogging, digital marketing, and how to run a successful website. To get access to exclusive discounts, free tutorials, and to stay in the loop on the latest happenings, sign up for our newsletter at oaklyn.com. And until next time, happy building.